Rav Chaim Kanievsky one time came to a place that lo aleinu they sit Shiva. And he told a story. He said one time Rav Michel Yehuda, one of the Gdolei Ador, asked to borrow a book from me. And he said, my father, Zichrono Livracha, was a God-fearing Jew, but not holy, meaning he wasn't a rabbi or a Rosh Yeshiva, but just a nice, very good, decent religious man. Few times when I walked with him on the street, he wanted to teach me Musar, ethics. He would point on a person and say, you see, he is like me. He is not a Talmid Chacham. He is not a great scholar of Torah. He works to make a living as a shoemaker, fixing shoes. But he has very good mazal. He has a son that is very high scholar of Torah, Talmid Chacham. You also, your father is not Talmid Chacham, but you should become Talmid Chacham. And when Rav Michel was telling that story to Rav Chaim Kanievsky, he said, I heard that son that my father pointed at, that man with his son, wrote a book, this Talmid Chacham boy that was a role model for me. My father was pointing at him every day when we passed by. He wrote a book, it's called Brit Etan, Solid Covenant. I heard you have it. I would like you to lend me that book for one day that I should learn in it. Why? As gratitude to this boy that thanks to him I became Talmid Chacham because I wanted to be like him, to imitate him. Now I want to pay him back by learning in his book, because if someone read your book, you get a big reward for it. Let me pay him back. I owe him. He inspired me. And Rav Chaim Kanievsky, when he came to the house of the mourning people, he said, after that I realized that I also owe gratitude to that writer of the book. Why? Because I learned Torah from Rav Michel Yehuda. And he became what he became thanks to that book. So I also owe him a lot of gratitude. I'll explain to you what it means. Sometimes you have a speaker or a rabbi or someone who train a student to also be a speaker, to also be a rabbi. I don't know, maybe he made him Baal Tshuva. He taught him how to speak, he taught him, he gave him idea, and the student also became very influential. So some people, they meet the student, they don't know that their gratitude is not only to that student who right now teaching them Torah. The gratitude has to be also to the one who made him who he is. And people usually don't like to pay gratitude to anyone. That's the nature of the people. They love to be ungrateful. Why? Because that's the best advice the Satan gives. The Satan makes us forget people that influence our life and we owe them a lot. Every once in a while, Hashem makes it that you will remember this person. After 5 years, someone came and talked about him next to you. You, as a fool, do not understand that Hashem is actually speaking to you right now from Shamayim. It's not that person. It's Hashem speaking to you. You ignore it. Smile. Yeah, yeah, great guy. No, that's not what Hashem sent him to talk about him next to you. Hashem expects you to have gratitude. But you don't have. Why? Gaon Mivilna, someone came to him and said, someone speak against you in the town, Lashon Hara. We are embarrassed. He said, I'm wondering, I don't remember doing any favor to that Jew. Why is he talking against me? If I did a lot of favors to him, I understand why he have the urge to talk against me. Because the Satan is trying to make him ungrateful. But he doesn't really owe me anything. What motivation he have to speak against me? It's the other way around. We would think, oh, he's my best friend. How can I talk against him? He did so much for me. I cannot talk against him. But in reality, it's the exact opposite. The more you owe the person, the more you stick the knife harder and deeper in his back. Unless you're a tzaddik. If you're a tzaddik, you work on yourself not to do it. But if you don't learn about the importance of gratefulness, you don't learn how much Hashem hates kfuye tova, ungrateful people, you don't learn about it. With the years, it becomes a way of life. Look at the children here in America. Connect each one of them to a lie detector. From 0 to 100, if one of them will reach 10% out of 100 in gratitude to his parents, I'll give you a prize. If there was a way to measure it with a lie detector. Do you appreciate your parents putting food for you every day? I take it for granted. Do you appreciate they send you to have a driver's license and about to buy you a car? My friends also have a car. No big deal. Yeah. Remember of Wallerstein Zatzal told a story about a girl here in Flatbush that her wealthy parents bought her a Volvo USV and she got very angry. She wants to run out of the house because it's a Volvo. Volvo, by the way, it's the car of the Prime Minister in Israel. That's what he gets, which is very fancy car. But in America, you know, they prefer maybe other cars. So she's 17 years old, her parents buying her a brand new Volvo, she just got her license. Instead of running and kissing their feet and dancing from happiness, oh, how much I owe you, thank you so much, she now cursing the parents and speaking and complaining and coming to the rabbi to tell them how abused she feels. Welcome to America.